Beware the military-industrial fundamentalist religion complex. If you put your faith in patriarchal systems, your spirit may sink like a rock in polluted waters. Obviously, if you are using an oracle like this, you probably don't have much faith in such systems anyway. But the danger they can generate still surrounds us. William Butler Yeats, in his apocalyptic poem, The Second Coming, talks about a time when the best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity. A good summary of a lot of what we're seeing on the news, at least in 2024. If you are part of the patriarchal complex, then you need to have some, not necessarily meaning that you're a willing part, but we're all part of it at this point in history. Then you need to have some passionate intensity to offset its machinations. Stay informed about politics and world events and find the area where you can most effectively oppose oppressive power systems. So some people are like, well, I don't listen to the news. It's too negative and stuff. This is the perfect attitude for those who want to take advantage and manipulate an uninformed populace. It's your responsibility as a system, as a citizen, to be informed. Sometimes the best opposition is indirect. The I Ching counsels that you only sharpen the fangs of evil when you resist it, and that the best rebellion from darkness is to make energetic progress toward the good. Well, I think that's often the best strategy. As a dynamic paradoxicalist, you can see my philosophy with the same name on the site. It's linked up in the card. I'm against absolutist positions and think some virulent cases of evil, Nazis come to mind, do require direct opposition. History is a nightmare from which I am trying to awake, said Stephen Dedalus, James Joyce's literary alter ego. Although we are presently incarnated within what I call the Babylon Matrix, see a glossary of Zap terms on the homepage of the site, the approximately 6,000-year period characterized by patriarchal dominator societies, see social historian Rianne Eisler's seminal work, The Chalice and the Blade, or a chapter 3, I think it is, of this book, which is free on the website, called Logos Beheld, which we'll get into, it's chapter 2 of this book. Find it on the homepage of the website. You can read chapter 2 for free. It will get into the same, much of the same material about the patriarchal society and how that could be about to transform and is transforming in some ways. We may also be on the cusp of a new eon where the age of nightmare empires metamorphoses into something new. And there are some other documents linked up there. I'm going to add a link to that in a moment. So don't remember that we live in interesting times. I know that's was considered by the Chinese to be a curse. Having said that, I don't know of an earlier time in human history that I would prefer, because this is a time of metamorphosis. But you do need to take steps to deal with the fact that we are living in a patriarchal era with a lot of dangerous things out there, even though we have the lowest per capita war death rate in all of human history and prehistory. So make use of this time, but also defend worthy living things from its encroachments and toxic elements.